Hi, I'm Brandon from the Xbox team. Today I want to share some tips on how developers can make gaming better for people who are colorblind. Color is one of the many components that makes gameplay immersive and fun, and it can be a fast and effective way to communicate information. However, relying on color to convey essential information can exclude gamers who are colorblind. One way to improve the gameplay experience is to avoid relying on color alone. Whenever possible, provide a secondary way to convey that same information, such as shape, text, symbol, or pattern. You can offer this second channel either by design or as a configuration option. Here's an example of a game that provides that second channel. In Hue, the object of the game is to capture colors and use these colors to manipulate your environment as you progress through the game. When colorblind mode is enabled, each color on the color wheel is paired with its own unique symbol. Colorblind players can reference those symbols during gameplay to differentiate between the elements. Here's how it looks to people who have one or more common types of colorblindness. Another common barrier encountered by people who have difficulty perceiving certain hues is contrast. For example, red on black may seem like a high contrast combination, but if you have difficulty perceiving red, then elements colored as red can be hard to distinguish from a dark background. Simulators, such as Color Oracle or Unreal's built-in tools, can help you uncover contrast issues in your game. The simulation in the previous scene was created with Color Oracle. If a secondary indicator isn't important, you might be tempted to think, "Oh, I can just use color filters to change the whole palette of the game." If you can use a filter to effectively simulate color blindness, then you should be able to use different filters to reverse it, right? Nope. Filters are usually not the best solution. They're a blunt instrument, changing elements that don't need to be changed, like turning the sun blue. They're also limited to the types of color blindness you specifically designed for, and they leave out people with less common conditions. Some conditions are even unique to an individual. If you can't avoid color reliance, like team color, then give control to the player instead. Let them choose the colors that work best for them. This means offering a range of colors, including light and dark, as Beat Saber does. Providing this freedom means you're able to cover the full spectrum of color deficiency, including less common types, such as people who can only see in black and white. Offering preset color palettes for common types of color blindness, like Ghost Recon Breakpoint does, can be helpful too. It saves players the effort of lots of configuration if their condition matches one of those presets. So ideally, offer both, presets for common conditions and a custom option that lets you freely configure the colors and color-reliant elements. So that's it. Thanks for watching and joining us on our journey to make gaming for everyone. To learn more, visit xbox.com/accessibility.